In this session, we will review the general maintenance procedures for our ABX-2L Flex Lance tractor. The general maintenance for this system is relatively simple, and you should be able to accomplish the procedures in 15 to 20 minutes. The tools required are a slot screwdriver, a 9/16 socket and socket wrench, anti-seize, and air tool oil. Begin by disconnecting the guide assembly from the tractor. Pull the lower quick-release pin from the exit end bracket and pivot the guide assembly upward. It will unhinge easily. Set the guide assembly aside. We'll look at belt tension first. Belt tension should be inspected periodically during routine maintenance and adjusted if necessary. Setting the proper belt tension is required to maximize belt operating life. Here's how to check the tension and, when necessary, change the belt. Spin the unit so you can open the back panel. Release the two pin locks on the sides to unlock the panel and open it up, exposing the serpentine drive system and the belt threaded around the sprocket rollers. The main thing here is to check the tension of the belt. This can be done easily at the job site, even when mounted to a positioner. To check the belt tension, make sure the rollers are in full open position as shown here. It may be helpful to insert a hose or round object between the rollers to maintain the full open position. This is important. Slide the section of hose through the inlet end, wear rings, and past all three drive rollers. Note: if using a hose, it should be the largest recommended size for the installed rollers to ensure they are open to the maximum position. Leave it in place there as you test the tension. Place your finger or a screwdriver directly over the two flathead screws as shown. Using 5 pounds of force, press down on the belt. The belt should deflect 0.2 to 0.3 inches. Use the top of the countersink as a guide. It is approximately 0.25 inches down from the nominal belt position. Here, the belt is too loose. Here, too tight. And here, just right. Note that the bottom of the teeth just touch the top of the countersink. Operating the system with a belt that is too tight or too loose will significantly reduce the operating life of the belt. If adjustments are to be made, the idler sprocket can be repositioned for correct tension. You can see the process at work as we change to a new belt. Use a 9/16 socket wrench to loosen the upper left-hand roller and slide it to the right. The belt will become slack and then it can be easily removed from the rollers. Examine the belt for wear and replace if necessary. Rethreading the belt properly is critical, and if you need assistance, there is a schematic diagram for the procedure in your operator's manual as well as on the web. Check the tension in the same manner as above, using the top left-hand idler sprocket to adjust the belt tension. With the belt on and tension checked, close the back panel and set the pin locks. Spin the unit around and repeat the same with the front panel, opening it up and exposing the drive rollers. There are three sets of drive rollers available for the 2L system, each set to be used with a specific range of hose diameters. The drive rollers are wear items and should be monitored. They change out easily using a slot screwdriver to trip the locking hub as shown. With the roller off, notice the key in each shaft and the keyway in each roller. Occasionally, the key will come out of the drive shaft when removing the roller. This is to be expected. Simply replace it in the shaft when installing the new rollers. One important note: be sure to apply anti-seize to each shaft before replacing the rollers. Otherwise, they may be difficult to remove next time. Snap the rollers into place, locking the hub each time. That's it for the inside. Close the front panel and set the pin locks. There is one final step for general maintenance, and it has to do with the length of downtime between job applications. If the system is to remain unused for 1 week or more, place a few drops of air tool oil in the two large air terminals. Here's how to do it. Tip the tractor so the front panel rests on the workbench. Removing the quick-release pins will help the unit lie flat. Remove the caps for the two large air terminals, but leave the small terminal alone. Place 3 drops of air tool oil into each of the large terminals. Do not put oil in the small terminal, shown here on the left. With the drops in place, connect a live air supply hose to each of the two large terminals and run air into the unit, sending the oil droplets into the motor. Replace the two caps and stand the unit back upright. If so desired, replace the guide assembly. Turning your attention to longer term maintenance, after a few hundred hours of operation, you'll want to check the wear items. As mentioned before, this includes the belt on the back side and the drive rollers on the front side. In addition, check the two wear rings here, the three guide blocks here, and generally, components where hoses pass through. On the guide assembly, you'll want to remove the quick release pin and check the interchangeable hose stop collet as shown here. That's it. Your general maintenance for the ABX-2L system is complete. If you have any questions or concerns, contact our technical specialists for assistance. Thanks for choosing StoneAge, and keep on blasting.